It would have been sometime in late 1975 that I remember riding on the top deck of a London bus, probably having a smoke on my way to the agency, as I became aware of a group of children behind me on their way to school. They were taking it in turns to raise their shoulders, roll their eyes, and intone in the deepest voice they could manage,
"Tell 'em about the honey mummy,"
at which point all would collapse in fits of laughter. And I felt a quiet glow of satisfaction. Perhaps the business I had somehow ended up in was not completely irrelevant to people's lives. My agency, Bowes Massimi Pollitt, had just launched a new TV campaign for a breakfast cereal called Sugar Puffs, owned by Quaker Oats. Sugar was already becoming a bit of a dietary turn-off, so we had chosen to associate the product with honey instead, which was seen as better for your kids. John Webster had created a character called Honey Monster, larger than a human, covered in yellow fur, wearing a baseball cap, and with all the characteristics of a five-year-old apart from his deep bass voice. He lived with a man whom he took to be his mummy. Yes, it was all very odd, but it was immediately hugely popular, as my experience on the bus indicated. It also sold a lot of sugar puffs, and Honey Monster is still the brand's well-known mascot today. You may think it a pointless exercise to attempt any analysis of just what it was about those ads that made Honey Monster such a popular success. Another attempt at murdering to dissect. I have some sympathy. But I also think it is possible to look at some of the characteristics of this campaign, qualities it has in common with many other popular hits, as suggested by Derek Thompson and others.